Welcome to the Wally Show Aftercast. All the things we did not get to during the course of the show today, including Gavin's new glasses. You still got them on?
I do, Chief.
Okay. Yeah. He got new glasses and he came in today and he debuted them for us. He came in with his old Gavin glasses and then debuted these. Describe them in your own words, Gavin.
Oh, okay. Let me take them off real quick just so we can do that. So you've got a kind of golden ish frame on the outside. The lenses have like a slight kind of leopard pattern to them, but it's very thin. And then you've got that like visor. No, what's it called? The sunglasses.
Aviators.
So like a little bit of an aviator thing across the top. No, not so much. Disagree.
No, go ahead. This is what I'm getting to. It's your description versus Betty's.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just seeing what I'm seeing. Well, now I can see better, too. Yeah. I haven't changed my prescription or gotten new glasses probably since.
And they're gold metal frames.
They're much heavier than the old ones.
And they were messing with them.
They have the actual nose piece on them.
Let me put them on, Rock. Let me see that. Oh.
See, those look good.
I did not think that it was possible to downplay her looks.
How's my vision?
It's really not that bad.
It never feels like it. Like, I can barely see. I can't read any. I can read this one. I can't read screens.
Rock,
but I've been told
wear
they're not too bad.
Aviators, the sunglass aviators. It's a fantastic look on you.
Do you feel like those are aviators?
Not really. They're kind of like they've got the bar across the top. Because it's funny because I have. In sunglasses, I have a similar pair to that with the bar across the top. And I like them for my sunglasses, but I didn't want to do them for my regular glasses.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that these could have been good transition lenses?
Yeah, that would be good. Yeah.
I do want to get some prescription sunglasses at some point. Yeah. And in my head, I didn't think that they would look as good with transition.
No, they work with
I'm starting to think they might have, and I regret that. Not doing that.
I do all my glasses with transitions, and I bought another pair of sunglasses because I don't always have them with me, and so I still always do the transitions because I do like it. They're not great, but I do like it. But I was like, oh, look at this. Bradley Cooper's here, because I think Bradley Cooper had a pair of glasses like this in a movie one time, but it was from the 70s. And then Betty's like, or Santa, I think you said.
Kris Kringle.
Well, have you ever seen Santa Claus is Coming to Town?
Yeah.
Like the ones, the stop and go motion ones. Like the old ones. Anyways, Gavin is just giving the old man vibe.
Okay.
Yeah. And so that's what I've been told.
You've got the
grandpa
glasses that to me give off a Dwight Schrute vibe. It's giving Dwight Schrute.
It's giving Dwight.
Oh, you just ruined it.
Oh,
it's also
no.
It's also giving like grandpa.
That I've
it's
already been told.
Giving young Santa.
Oh no.
They do have
giving Dwight is brutal.
That's tough.
Like she told me I look like a 50s NASA scientist with my new glasses.
They are Dwight's glasses. That's such a bummer.
We're going to never be able to unsee that. Can you do a picture of him and Dwight side by side for socials?
I'll see what people
say.
Do you
want me to?
It.
I'll try and part my hair down the middle.
Like him. You totally should. I don't think it's a bad look for you,
thanks.
But I just don't think it's Bradley Cooper.
Okay.
But I mean,
you're right.
What
that
is?
Like, Wally started off on the wrong description.
Yeah, you went way overboard.
I know, but I'm a nice person.
Can I look
like,
at Bradley?
Wait, when?
Yeah,
when
all
did
the
that
time.
Begin?
All the time I care about young
glasses.
Gavin. I know how I can be undone when I get glasses and then people comment on them.
Wait a second.
Like, and they're brutal about it. You're like, oh, okay, well, I didn't need that. you know, and I knew Betty was going to take his little legs out. So I'm like, I wanted to prop him up and give him a pillow to fall on.
I mean,
I think they're a bad look. I'm just saying, let's be honest.
So there's Bradley Cooper.
Okay, it's got that sleazy 70s.
That was it. Yeah, that was the same glasses. It was from a 70s movie,
he
I think.
He looks like he looks like a mobster.
Yeah.
He was, I think
whereas,
that was one where he's like FBI thing.
Yeah. Whereas you look more like.
I think this is War Dogs.
It looks like we went to go visit Grandpa on the lake in his boat.
Oh. Huh.
Yeah. And where he's a retired. He's a retired. What do you call the people that do a lot of math and stuff?
No, mathematician.
No, like an accountant.
Physicist. Oh,
a
accountant.
I should be adding people's taxes.
And now you put together fishing boats in bottles.
Oh. None of which I can do.
That's what it's giving.
It is. That's what it gives.
Yeah.
All of that.
It is interesting because there was a pair of glasses that I had picked out and I was putting them on and I'm like, okay, I kind of like these. These are pretty cool. And then I got up to the desk to enter the prescription and match them to the frames. And the lady who was working was like, do you want to maybe go get some different ones? Because those ones look kind of small in your head.
Interesting.
And Haley had already told me that she's like, I think you should look at some others just in case. So Haley had already handed these to me, and they were my second option of like, oh, I still like these other ones better. And so
you listen to the lady that worked there, and maybe even over your wife.
Oh. Actually, yeah. That's a good point.
We talked about that on the regular show.
It's interesting that she said that they were small for your head. So she was giving you advice on what she thought looked good for you.
When my wife went to get her glasses, we were at a place, and I think we were at Costco. And my wife puts on glasses, and the lady goes, nope, those aren't for you. Those don't work for you. Those are not good. Those are bad. Mm-hmm. And was really direct about it. And and I thought, oh, this is going to make my wife mad, because I thought they were cute on her. And I asked her, I said, is that making you upset? And she's like, no, I appreciate it. I'm like,
no,
what?
Because, I get that, because there's so many decisions. Like, there's too many options. And you just need someone to be... not blunt or rude, but you just need someone to be like, yes, no.
Because you know how I say, like, hurt people when I say something, like, to excuse
it? Like what you
it?
Did with your wife with her red pants.
Oh, yeah. Like, oh.
And asking her if she was a
gondolier in training.
A gondolier, yes.
But, like, this lady goes, the lady justified it by going, she goes, look, I don't get paid commission, so I'm just trying to tell you what looks best on you. Like, okay, well, there you go. And I ended up liking the lady, but if it had upset my wife, then I would have been mad. But where my wife was okay with it, I'm like, okay, then have at it. It's a roast over here.
What does Haley think, Gavin?
Oh, like, what does she like them? Oh, yeah, no, she loves them. She thinks that they are a deviation from what I've done for the last, like, two sets of glasses.
I get that.
And I think that maybe in her mind, she's seeing this jumping on the old man glasses trend. And maybe she, like, pushed me on to that little boat because this wasn't the direction I was leaning when I went in.
Sure.
I thought I'd go in and choose like some like nifty clear frames and maybe white just to like get like in my
head. Glasses have gotten to me. He's even using words like nifty.
Yeah. I've been saying nifty for years.
I'm telling you, cool beans. I still think I am an old soul, but you, sir, are already at grandpa level.
Yeah.
Like you're good to go.
I'd rather skip the whole dad phase and just be the fun
you're
grandpa.
Just right there.
You'll get to even it up when Betty Rock gets her glasses here soon.
I'm hoping that you can get those.
I got to get the insurance situation all figured out. But once I do that,
Because
I did the whole trying on thing.
Online.
Yeah.
You tried a lot of glasses on.
Yeah, they did the Warby Parker thing and they sent like 10 different ones. That was a lot.
That is the problem when you go, like Zach used to always say, it's better to have less choices because when you get too many choices, it definitely makes it harder. And when I went to look for my glasses, I saw the same frames that I've had for years in about 20 different pairs of glasses. Mm-hmm. And I told my wife, I said, well, I want to do something different this time.
We always say that.
Yeah, I'll get another pair. And I did this time, I'll get another pair next year. Stop it. I can feel the judgment.
I'm not saying anything.
Yeah, you did.
No, I'm not. Saying his gives, what's that movie with the
Hidden Figures?
Yes.
Yes, Hidden Figure vibes.
It gives Hidden Figure vibes. Oh, for sure. Yeah. It gives Houston, we have a problem vibes.
Yeah. And I'm good with that. I'm good with that. So it'll be interesting to see what you pick on your own.
Yeah.
And so,
I wanted to read to you a couple of things from posts from Poddies on our Facebook group.
Oh, sure.
There you go. I like it. So we have a potty group. If you want to join, this is where we just kind of keep in touch with our potties. You can text the word potty, P-O-D-D-I-E, to 91979, and we'll send you that link so you can join. But Laura, she was listening to, if you listened to the podcast earlier, then you know what she's talking about. For our Name It and Claim It, where today we named a cat.
Yeah.
I forget for what the
name.
It was
an animated cat. Little guy. Yeah.
But I forget what the name of the girl was. That
Birdie.
Birdie. Okay.
Oh, so
well,
cute.
She said, I came up with Frankie and you said
Schizo. Yeah.
Schizo, which for some reason Gavin chose as the winner, which was really dumb. But Laura Beth, she said, for the cat with the boots, combine the two names, Schizo and Frankie, and give her Fritz.
Oh.
I was thinking it was going to be like Schizofrankie.
Yeah, that's good too. Yeah,
or something.
Yeah, that's good too.
Fritz? Isn't Fritz? That's good.
On the Fritz.
It's good. Yeah, it's good. Yeah. Okay. I mean, I don't hate it.
I'm moving on. Brittany. Brittany said, I have a suggestion for the Heaven's Fire t-shirt.
Oh, please do tell.
So on the Aftercast, you had said, like yesterday, you had said on the back it needs to have world tour, but with a date on
right,
it. Just one
date.
And that's
yeah.
it. She said maybe it should be February 30th.
That's so great.
It is. That's
oh
a,
my goodness.
That's a great idea.
That is great. Because I could even, I know the club, like you could put Club 777,
that's so funny.
Which was a real place that we played. Uh-huh. Club 777, mm-hmm. Coral Springs, Florida.
Oh my, was that a Christian club?
Yes, it was. No. Yeah. Seven, and then do the date of like whatever. And yeah. then
wouldn't that be great?
7:30. Yeah.
I love that idea.
Oh, 2:30. Yeah, that's really
yeah,
good.
Yeah, I love that idea.
Yeah.
And then Jessica. She has been hearing us talk about AI a lot.
Yeah.
Well, she found this video. This is someone who took My Heart Will Go On, Celine Dion's Titanic
oh.
song. Now, this is Freddie Mercury, but they got AI
to do it
in his voice.
No.
And it is shocking.
No, I want to hear this. Like I could see if they got like Mark from
down here
to do this because he can do a perfect Freddie Mercury imitation. Like I could see that being that, but that as AI generated is not that far
no,
off.
No, it's so good. And that's what's creepy.
Yeah, like if you were listening to that, because there's the little warbles and stuff from the AI, but like if you're just listening to that in passing or like not, like we got headphones on right now, mm-hmm. like you would hear that and be like, what yeah, did he do? How did he do that?
Because if you didn't know, Freddie Mercury, he died in the
80s, yeah.
Yeah, and Celine Dion's song, that was in 95,
wow.
maybe. So it wasn't even during his time. It's just amazing that they could recreate it with his voice.
That is really scary for music and stuff, too. Like, I don't think AI is really good at writing songs yet and like, being creative like that. Mm-hmm. But the audio stuff in the picture stuff is amazing.
Yeah.
It's going to be harder and harder. I think that the problem is, too, like, deep fakes are going to be a problem. Like, because you mm-hmm. could then take a celebrity and make them say
happened.
Whatever they want you want them to say.
Yeah, there was
and
something
cause
to do with
problems.
Drake, I think.
Yeah.
And he ended up suing someone.
Yeah, because they put him basically in a song, AI version.
Yeah,
of Drake,
and it wasn't him.
In a song. But yeah, mm-hmm. you could do that. Or you could have them saying inflammatory things.
Yeah.
Because once it's on the internet, like, it doesn't go away. Mm-hmm. And it's hard to stop that train. You could say all day, well, that wasn't me. This will be the new thing. Okay. This will 100% be the new thing. I got hacked. It was the thing when you did mm. something dumb and you were like, I got hacked. And you just blamed it on that. Now it'll be, I got AI'd.
Mm-hmm.
I got AI. It wasn't me. I got AI'd. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. that is crazy. Gavin, I have a little bit of audio. If you could pull it up for me in there. It's the one about the statue. Mm. If you could put that up for me, please. There are members of a Houston megachurch that decided to exorcise a demonic influence from their church the other day.
What?
Yeah. So apparently they found a little Grim Reaper miniature statue hidden on the property and they were freaked out by it. And the local news even came to do a story.
Tonight, a congregation gathered to pray away the devil after a statue of death was found at the Community of Faith Church.
This is sacrilegious.
It's a statue that announces curses. We destroy the works of the devil.
Man, when you hear stuff like this on the news, it freaks me out. Like, just because it not doesn't freak me out, it bothers me because it's so stupid and it makes Christianity look stupid. Mm-hmm. You know, like, okay, you found a little like ceramic figurine on your, you know, thing. Throw it away. away. It's a dumb trinket. It doesn't have any power over you. You know the name of Jesus binds everything in the world. Like, you don't have to give it that space. But so they give it that space. They make a big deal of it. They make an issue of it. So then they think, oh, I'm getting the gospel out there. No, you're looking like lunatics for the rest of us, man. Mm-hmm. And it frustrates me to no end. Like, anytime I just hearing how they're talking, not even the church, but like the news people, and they're going to pray it away, you know, like it's just, it's such a bad look on Christianity, man. And so they get all around it. This is the best part, though. It's so ridiculous. So they pour olive oil on it, extra virgin oil from Kroger. literally, like no ceremonial oil. They're like, oh, we got to anoint it. So let's anoint it. And then they light it on fire. They break it. They don't even have a hammer. They have like a carabiner, and they're like hitting it with that. And they break it. You look like Neanderthals that are afraid of the sun. You know, and this is what people see of Christianity. And it just, it's so sad to me. And so, like, before crushing it, they had prayed over it and stuff like that. Like, I know spiritual warfare, but this doesn't, there's no way this counts as spiritual warfare, some trinket that somebody left there.
The only thing I could see is that maybe they've been having, like, threats put towards the church, and so maybe they're thinking this is part of it. Okay. I don't know.
So their church was robbed. So somebody stole a safe and stole money from them.
Okay.
So then, okay, you go, okay, that was lame. That shouldn't happen. But cars get broken into, houses get, it's nothing new. Mm-hmm. It doesn't mean it's spiritual warfare. It just means that you have a broken world with bad people that you had stuff they wanted to steal, you know. But then to take this little figurine and be like, this was a sign and it's a curse, and we just as random people are going to pour olive oil on it, set it on fire, and now the curse is done. Yeah. Okay, God can work now. Phew, we saved it. Like, it just kills me, man. Like, do you honestly believe that this little statue is evil enough that you have to exorcise, you know, this thing, and you're a mega church. How bad are things going for you? You know, like, this thing was destroying your life. If your church is going well, it had no power anyway, you know. And if you had never seen it, you would have never known it was there. Mm-hmm. But then you see it and you give it power. Mm-hmm. That's the difference. We give so many things power in our lives, whether it's addiction, whether it's, you know, statuettes, we assign power to them, and then it controls us.
Our thoughts, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. And then you go and you do dumb things, you know, like this one. It probably says made in China on the bottom. Do you want to be afraid? Be afraid of that. Be afraid that China makes everything we have. Like, that's where your fear should be, and that they own half of our country.
Where is our rant bed,
Gavin? Oh, I don't have a rant bed. I got rid of it because it's just, what's a rant bed?
You
don't
need rid of it?
No, I'm just kidding. Rant is every day.
You need to just always have it available, because you never know what's going to set him off. It could be a little doll, death doll.
It is. It's a little, well, they did. They said it's a precursor to curses. Like, really? Oh, do I have a podcast rant? Yeah. I forgot about that.
Oh, I have a medical condition, all right. It's called caring too much, and it's incurable.
We should just start putting that up on every time we do the podcast, because it seems like there's a lot of these.
This one got you today.
It did, because like, I take this stuff seriously. I hate the optics of it for what it makes people look, what it makes all of Christianity look like. It makes us all look like we're afraid, out of touch, and like we're lunatics. Mm-hmm. And that's what I don't like. I think it does more harm than it does good, you know.
Did someone say that you're giving this too much power?
No. I'm just shedding light on it, like we should when the Bible tells us to. Shed light on false doctrine.
That's what the Bible tells us.
Wait, you got to end it right. You got to end it right.
Oh.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, I have a medical condition, all right. It's called caring too much, and it's incurable.
What you didn't see there was me punching the monitor with my knuckle because it wouldn't fire.
Oh, someone is on a tirade. Well, you know what? You didn't get a lot of sleep last night because you were watching a show. And
yeah.
You weren't responsible.
Really? Yeah, my wife.
And,
we
didn't
watched
go to bed.
We
in a
watched
reasonable
the show.
Hour.
And we watched the cliffhanger, and then we're like, oh, let's watch the next few minutes of it. And then that drug into another hour, and it was like, oh, it was already way too late. Yeah, and then I was in a good mood, like coming back and stuff like that, and then something else set me off this morning.
So. Oh, when Jake came in.
Yeah, I'm a little edgy
today. It's just Jake.
Yeah, no, it wasn't Jake's fault either. It wasn't Jake's fault. Lady Rock, what do you got?
On TikTok, there's a new viral challenge, and pretty much what it is it's based off the Barbie movie that just came out. So in the movie, Margot Robbie, she gets out of her Barbie shoes, and when she does, her feet are still in that curved arch position,
okay.
Like the Barbie is.
I saw this
Barbie
in the trailer, and I love special effects, and I love how they accomplish things. And I literally thought when she walks and she just comes right up out of the shoes and the shoes don't even move, I'm like, okay, how did they accomplish that? Because if you try to take your shoes off, they're going to move a little. Ooh. They stay perfectly put, and her foot comes perfectly out of it. And I was trying to figure out how they did that.
They did that with double-sided tape.
That makes sense.
And to get the scene, she had a bar for balance. So she could grab onto that bar and then step out of the shoes and still have the curve in her feet. Well, anyways, people saw this part of the movie and now they are redoing it on TikTok. A lot of people are. But some doctors, some podiatrists are very concerned about this, okay? They said 1 to 2 times.
Oh, I have a medical condition, all right? It's called caring too much and it's incurable!
Stop it, podiatrist. No one cares what you have to say about the feet, especially when it comes to 1 second in a movie and people standing on their toes.
Here's what they had to say. Would you like to get all the information first? Before you have a time.
Absolutely not.
Okay, so they said 1 to 2 times. That's totally fine. Make a great TikTok video. We get it. But if you're attempting it multiple times, that could be bad. They said the pose and stride over long periods, there's some risk involved. The ankle is unstable, which can lead to ligament sprains and injuries commonly seen with high heel uses. Just going to show the actual shot was done with the woman, the actress holding on to the bar.
Yeah.
So it's not like it was... It is humanly possible, and maybe you could do it 1 or 2 times, but don't keep doing it over and over.
Sure.
Because the podiatrists are concerned.
I know, and thank you, podiatrists. If you're a podiatrist, thank you for keeping us safe today, because I was not sure how anyone was going to survive walking on their tippy toes. Like, come on, man. Like, I love that everyone feels like they've got to weigh in on things. Well, I'm a podiatrist. Hey, there's a foot in the thing. That looks dangerous. I better weigh in on this. It's so funny to me, man. Like, seriously? You think this is going to be a trend? Sorry, hold on.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, I have a medical condition, all right? It's called caring too much, and it's incurable!
You think this is going to be an epidemic all of a sudden of people walking around on their tippy toes?
If anything, it's more business for them, so I don't see why they're complaining.
I don't know. You could have, like, little girls that maybe go see it and decide, like, oh, I'm going to walk like
that. That's right, Gavin. I didn't think about that.
Full time, yeah.
Girls.
Maybe.
You know what? Women walking on high heels, that is dangerous for them enough. Let's get rid of high heels. Let's just get rid of high heels, because that's dangerous. Yeah. What's your highest heel, Lady Rock?
Do you ever wear high heels?
Yeah, very rarely.
Yeah.
I don't know, maybe 2 inches.
Oh yeah, yeah. You have small heels. You don't wear like a 4-inch heel.
Not like the chunk.
Yeah.
No.
Those are scary. Stilettos? Is that what it is?
Well, like, now, if I had a man who was like
tall.
6'4", I'd probably wear them more often.
Yeah, I get that.
But because it's just me, I'm like, there's no need.
I get that.
Yeah.
I get that.
Yeah.
So,
want to go to birthdays?
Let's go to birthdays.
Let's have happy celebratory.
Let's see if there's a rant in birthdays.
I have a medical condition, all right? It's called caring too much, and it's incurable!
It's incurable!
All right, what do you got?
Okay, so we don't have any birthdays.
Oh, geez.
But we do have a question.
Okay, go.
It's from Brayton. Brayton said, what tool would you 3D print to solve one of your everyday problems? So he said, for example, I printed a tool that helps me hold open a book only using one thumb.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Or one hand.
Oh, okay. That's a good idea.
That's smarter than...
Solves a problem. That's better than mine. I was like a 3D hammer to hit this screen with.
Because
I hurt my knuckle when I was...
You did?
Yeah, I pushed...
You did?
I pushed my knuckle up like a noogie and was punching the screen like that, and it actually hurt my knuckle.
Something's gonna break.
Yeah,
we're gonna have to tell Engineer Phil.
Yeah, hey, it should have worked in the first place.
I would 3D print some arches that I could use to keep my feet in Barbie position.
That's a great idea. Mm-hmm. And then podiatrists would come at you hardcore online and go after you. Gavin,
I went with I would do a 3D fan that's built into a hat
to
solve that issue where you're getting in the car and it's too hot and the AC hasn't kicked in yet. Yes. So it solves that. You turn it on as you leave the building. So it's hitting you, you get in the car, still hitting you. And then the AC gets to that temperature and
you
turn it off.
You know what you need? This past Sunday, I tried it. My friend, she had one of those, you charge them.
Oh, it's like a necklace?
It's a neck fan. It around your neck and it's a fan.
I think I've seen those.
It was amazing.
Was it?
It would blow your beard out. Yeah, it would give it the blown effect.
My wife had some of those when they went to Disney in the summer. She and Molly, her friend, they went and they had them. They were like, this was one that was a small one you could hold out away from you.
Oh, no, this is like one that
goes
just
around
like
your
neck.
This was one they had around for you. And Molly just like shoved it in her shirt. Like, she's
I don't blame her.
I'm so hot. That's how she wore it.
I understand.
Yeah. All right. Well,
what would you do?
Oh,
I said the hammer.
Make a hammer.
Had you thought of something more creative before the?
No.
All righty.
Yeah. Sounds like it.
And on that note, thanks for being a potty. Growing up in poverty has never been easy for children, but with the added challenges of the pandemic, conflict, and natural disasters, families around the world are facing an unprecedented food crisis. Unfortunately, those who are already hungry are now even more desperate. But by sponsoring a child through Compassion, you can help provide life-sustaining essentials such as food and clean water. And with your compassionate support, that child can not only survive, but also flourish. You can find out how and choose a child to sponsor when you click on the Compassion banner at wayfm.com.